So I had the choreography myself, but after Anne, I can't compete. So I'll do you a favor. Thank you, because this is so inspiring. And I'm feeling like a child, because 6 months ago, we established the safeguarding office in the Italian Federation. And this is fantastic, because I can see what we can do. We are just at the beginning, but we all know how important it is to set it out right from the outset, from the beginning. And we're trying. And gosh, I found all the keywords, the challenges, oh, but the resources, people that are going to step down, people are going to leave. I see all the challenges. And we got the same words everywhere in the world. And when I see what, Sue, what you have done here in the UK, and I know how inspiring it was Lily yesterday, thank you. And this is fantastic, because you are paving the way and we can follow. So I thought, okay, this is crucial. So thank you for having me, for having our federation, because sharing knowledge, sharing experience is crucial. But I can say we have an experience to share. I can say that we got commitment to share. And maybe one point we are working on. So we have the same keywords, and this is very important, but what we are dealing with, because this is the very beginning, is the governance. Well, Italy, as you might know, we have some legal body, some information which are not relevant to my opinion. Well, the only thing, the only point is we adopted a mixed formula as for the composition. So I'm a lawyer, I'm sorry, I apologize. But we have an athlete, and she is the vice president of our Olympic Committee, because the Olympic Committee is into this. And we are the first federation doing this in Italy. And you know what? 2 months later, another federation, dance, they are joining. So they call on me, they say, oh, let's do something. And now another federation is following. So, and we're just at the beginning. I mean, we are still writing the strategy, the plan, and they're following suit. And this is fantastic. So, well, if they just saw what you've done, Sue, what this country has done, this is fantastic. So thank you. And I have a notebook full of, you know, ideas and things to do and actions. And I'm following suit as well. And then they follow as well. This is what this is all about. It's about sharing. And the mixed composition, we got another member is a psychologist. And we're just three of us. And we're trying to do the job, which is huge. And now we are going to have a list of, you know, some experts we can resort to. But at the very beginning, just three of us. And people saying, oh, this is going to be an issue. I say, we are not the issue. And we are not the solution, because this is wrong. The solution is in the federation. The solution, well, coaches, athletes, and managers, they are the solution altogether. But we're trying to make you understand that we are not the issue. The safeguarding policies are not the issue. And do you recall this? It was the beginning for you like this. You know, you are the issue, really. And we have people coming forward right now. And this is good. This is an opportunity. We know it hurts. We know that. And we are in that moment. But it's also an opportunity. And if you change this as an opportunity, like you did, we can try to carry out a revolution, even in a traditional country like Italy. So, in my opinion, three federations working on this, it's already something. And since we have seen your experiences, what we are trying to do is, first of all, adapting to the Italian governance. We've got something which is very peculiar. We have an organization which is very structured about sport justice. So we've got a code, a sport justice code. I had the honor in 2014 to be one of the drafters, one of the writers. So I can say nothing but good about that, but don't take my words for that, of course, because I'm clearly biased. And so this is all, well, I'm a lawyer, so it's all about the justice, but just justice is about enforcement, which is about redressing, maybe deterrence, but it's about redressing. And this is not what we need. Because as you know, abuses, they cause a damage, and damage cannot be recovered. So it's fair, and we need enforcement, but it's not enough. It's not like something else which will give them an example, which set the example. Yes, it's true, but we need to work on prevention. We need to work on information, and we've got some ideas. But when you have such a, you know, say structured judiciary, because this is a judiciary, it's even independent. So we got a federal prosecutor, a general prosecutor, within the Olympic Committee, that we've got sport courts, so trial courts, courts of appeal, the Supreme Court, it's all very state justice-like, okay? And you need to find your room, your way for that, because the first reaction is, oh, but this is responsibility for this and for that. Okay, I see that, but they don't have the powers to do what we are trying to do. And because we're going to work before, and justice is you can enforce it when there is a violation, or an alleged violation, of course. And then, you know, redressing through sanctions, it's not the way we should be working. It's not the only way we should be working. So the first step was, I'm sorry, we are here, and do you mind if? Do you remember this stage? And this is where we are. But we are lucky because we've got a president of our federation is supporting this. The president of the Olympic Committee is supporting it, and having the vice president of the Olympic Committee, and I myself, the attorney for the Olympic Committee, you know, in state justice. So we can work on both sides, which is important at the beginning. The general prosecutor is fantastic, is doing this plan with us. So we exchange the information, and this is working. But my first fear was, okay, they're going to stop because of powers, power games, you know that. And this is all about, especially in our country. But we managed to. But 6 months is nothing. So we're still working on a plan. We need resources. So JG now is, where resources? Well, you know, we are chronically understaffed, and, you know, everywhere. We rely on volunteers. So when you bring up another, you know, line of costs, which is what we are at the beginning, but we are opportunity, then the question is, okay, but what about resources? And let's establish a foundation, sponsor, they will follow, they will help. And if they see the plan, if they see the vision. So we did the other way around. Okay, let's start with a vision, with a plan, and then maybe we will have resources and people doing that. So it's a sort of learning by evolving and evolving by learning. Because this is the only way we can do that right now, until a big problem comes up. And that's the opportunity, because people are going to wake up, it's hurtful, but it works. I'm sorry to say that, but you know this is true. And that's what's happening. So for some months we've been looking for, you know, we're trying to gather resources. Now maybe we're going to have a further push on that, and this is fantastic. But the way we had to start, it was so hard, you know, finding the room. But we had an unexpected support by coaches. And I say unexpected because in so many experiences, especially in the beginning, there was the polarization. And the polarization is not useful. We know that. This is a win-win case. Or it's going to be a lose-lose. We cannot afford it. So the idea is, okay, they do the enforcement, so back to the governance, they do the enforcement. We do the prevention through information education, sharing knowledge and experiences. Now, in Italy, finally, starting from 2023, if you want to be licensed as a coach, there is a mandatory module on this. This is big for us. And I know I sound like a child, but because we are. And this is also, you know, the first step. And second, from 2024, we will have safeguarding for parents as well. And I saw it, so, okay, I need to replicate it. So I'm going to steal from you, just to let you know. Thank you. And counseling. The big problem we had in Italy is the safeguarding policies. They're, all the clubs, they were in charge of it. And it's dramatic. And because, you know, this is so much. And a single club cannot do that. They need a duty officer, they need the plan correct, but they need to be heard and followed by the Federation. So we say, okay, we're not like a court, we're not like, you know, a prosecutor. If you come to us, we do not, you know, start a file, investigation. You can come to us when there is the early warnings or if you have an issue and you need, you know, an advice. Because we got, you know, the psychologist, we got an international athlete, and I'm a lawyer, so maybe there was a legal problem. I can do that. And so, you know what? In 6 months, 20% there were cases where they needed us to intervene, and we did that through the enforcement, along together with, of course, the prosecution and the prosecutor and the sports justice. But 80% of cases, people, coaches, asking us for advices. This is a situation, I can see this is coming. What can I do? Or a parent, and this is great. I know we're still very ineffective. I know that, and I feel for that, believe me. It's true, I sometimes I don't sleep for this, but it's good, because it means that we are doing something, and which is we are conveying a message. You're not alone, the Federation is here, and you can call on us, and we are there, just drop a line, make a phone call. And so after the first coach, the second coach came forward, and this is fantastic, because usually there is the polarization, and we can see them working together with us. And so we came up with this idea, sorry, just, you know, the early warnings, and the quick response, by the way, the other issue with the sports justice, with just justice broadly speaking, they need time, and it makes sense. Because, you know, they're all the principles to comply with, and I believe those principles. The procedure is not just procedural aspect, it's a guarantee. So that makes sense. But sometimes, when there is an issue, you need a quick response. So what we can do, totally different policy, totally different strategy, is, okay, we don't know whether this case is, you know, has got legal grounds for that, but meanwhile, we see there is pain, we can intervene. Which means we can, maybe you can move the athlete, you can do something in the meantime. While there is proceeding going on. Because we are not a court, and there are some advantages in not being a court, and a court of law. And detecting the early warnings, and so we came up with this idea. Okay, let's do something which is about involving coaches and athletes. Let's try from the outset not to polarize this kind of challenge, this kind of issue. Let's convey this message that coaches, together with the athletes, together with managers, they are the solution, they are not the issue. For a couple of reasons. First of all, when they establish the safeguarding office, you know the first reaction, phone calls, to the Federation, I'm going to be completely genuine and straightforward. Phone calls to the Federation, you know, from coaches. Oh, the witch hunt has begun. This was shocking. The witch hunt? And so we decided to start from coaches. So the first 2 weeks, there were meetings with coaches to reassure them, we are here to work with you. And we know that 99% of the Federation is working great, but even 1%, we cannot accept it. Even one case. So it's the zero case, it's a goal. So let's work on that. Please, you can come to us when you detect an early warning. Did you have a psychologist before the safeguarding officer to help you in case you have an issue? No. So now you are in a better situation than yesterday. There was no reason to be concerned. So the very first impact was getting over, you know, some concerns from coaches. And then the moment we got, okay, they are with us because they are writing, I see this problem. I've got, you know, a young athlete. I can see there is a problem with, you know, the dietary regime. I'm talking to parents and they do not listen. And this is the indication this is working. And we are just at the beginning. And you can see in this kind of, you know, teamwork, there is still one tail missing, parents. Because right now we don't know how to activate them. Sometimes they are on the other side, they don't see. Sometimes they are against because they see the coaches as the issue. So we need to work with them because they are, along with the coaches, the first moment where we need to manage any kind of issue and any kind of abuse. I came here to learn, and I'm learning, so I'm very grateful. And we are at the very, very, very beginning. But I also know that, and tell me if I'm wrong, please, that on the spectrum of the abuses, because this is a spectrum, there is a gray area where the wrong words are, okay, it's a difference in the perception. Oh, because now it's different. I really don't believe that. I truly don't believe that. 20 years ago, 3 decades ago, that kind of behavior or conduct was perceived in a different way or was anyhow acceptable. It's just people, they didn't have, you know, the courage to come forward. So coming forward is a good indication. And this is not about perception. It's about how we can work on that end of the spectrum. Because, you know, on this side, when there is the physical abuse, I don't think that prevention can stop those very few cases, hopefully. And you need the enforcement, the strong enforcement, and you need to prevent by watching. But the prevention in sense of information can work a lot on these ends of the abuses, where the perception is wrong, maybe, okay, so we're going to tell you and to give you the technical strategies. The standards, by the way, standards. When I came up with the idea, shall we, you know, write down some standards, some best practices that all the single clubs, they can try to, the president of the federation say, yes, let's do that. And then I had, you know, some voices say, oh, new rules? New standards, but you know, clubs, how can they comply with those? They've got so much to do. And you see, it's always that problem. But I don't see that a problem. I don't see that an argument. I see that as an excuse. Well, resources and the lack of it cannot be the excuse. So what I'm now about to say, it may be controversial, but I welcome cases because they are also the opportunity. And then, if we've got some cases now, and we didn't have cases 6 months ago, maybe it's also because people can now come forward, or the indication gave the right sign. You can come forward. And the coaches, they can feel they can come forward. So even just this is a way we can trigger the change. So I don't know if we are about to revolutionize this in Italy. I do hope so. But I know that the trigger, we have it, and we triggered it. We try to trigger this involvement of coaches. Coaches, they're not on the other side. They are with us, and they are the very first subject, along with the parents. They need to watch, and we can use to prevent it. Because if this is all about enforcement, okay, we can do that. We'll see all the allegations, and that will be investigating, and it takes time. And then the recovery, yes, I don't think generally the recovery is going to work. But on the side of the prevention, how can we do this with our coaches? Not to mention that if you polarize this, it's going to be a coach to serve as a coach in future. And we will have a safe sport with no coaches. Really? So we are at the beginning, we are learning, but we were so lucky to have some support and to find in the coaches the key to start this journey. Please help us, support us, and allow us to copy you, because this is what we are going to do, because we were just at the beginning, but it's good news, and thank you.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much.
Thank
you. Pierre Luigi.